Hello YouTube, my name's John. This is an extra little video in my fibre optic series. This is a new couple of ducts that have been put in. The left hand one goes under the road. The contractors that put power into these two properties popped an extra duct in for me, and that feeds into the system. Then these two, they just have single core armoured cable. The two run under the grass here where I'm walking, down to the fence line, and then round to the back of the properties where they enter, and they feed into the property supplies. The final duct follows those across, but at the fence line it carries on across the front of the property. It heads over towards the wall. Now it was going to go where that dark patch in the grass was, but instead now it does a 90 degree and comes down the side of the wall here all the way to the back corner of the property, where it terminates in a grey box like you saw at the front. And here you have it. This is a small cut-off piece of the ducting you saw there. It's actually 20mm HDPE water pipe, which is rated for above or below ground. In this instance, it's very sturdy. It's a nice little drop tube, effectively, for a fibre. The cable that you saw there, or that was running through there, was this 12-core XL loose tube, gel-filled. And yeah, here, this section, it runs through very easily, but it has got a bit of a kink to it. And there are a lot of 90-degree sweeps in there, which made pulling it through, which I did try to start with, a little bit tricky. Actually, the connector I had on the end came off the first time. So back to the drawing board, needed to use some lubricant. This is Yellow 77 from Ideal. There are plenty of other types of lube out there. This is wax-based. Silicon is also available. It's quite gloopy, this stuff. The silicon's a little bit less so, a little bit more watery. Only problem with this is you really need to be, as you feed the cable in, you need to be lubing the cable and the duct as it goes in. However, you can't both be lubing that in and pulling it out the other side. So if you've got no friends like me, you're a little bit stuffed, which is where this comes in. Now this is the Lube Master 2000. It's 12 volts battery powered. I have designed the case big enough to put an internal battery in, but I haven't ordered that up yet, and it's a little bit pointless. This is a 20mm coupler with a slot cut into it and hole drilled for the feed pipe at an angle. So you insert the pipe into your duct and the coupler sits over there. So when you push your cable in, you would have a pull string, the two sort of touch each other and the lube is pumped onto the cable. On the left hand side we have a port for a massive syringe which you fill up with your lube, then the syringe simply sits in the port there. A peristaltic pump which uses three rollers, and it rolls and squishes and squeezes a very floppy silicon hose to create a vacuum on this side and then a pressure on that side, which then sucks and forces out the lubricant. On-off switch and a manual button here. Just take that out. Now you might think, oh, that's brilliant, but if you push that you still have to be at the start of the cable. Well, this has a remote control, so you can be, you know, 100 meters or so away and still run it, which is fantastic. If you're pulling, you're sorted. Let's have a look inside. So I've taken the screws out already. Inside is a little RF receiver. Look on eBay for these, they're around everywhere. They're £5 at the most. This is a 12 volt one for the 12 volt battery. Now the peristaltic pump is actually only 6 volts, so there's some dropper resistors. You'd probably be better off getting the 12 volt one in the future. I just had this hanging around. some 3mm ID tubing with couplers, and then some buttons. Really simple, nothing else. There's space for a battery internally. That's it. So, let's get it going. We'll pop that in there. Before I start, there's just a little bit of rubber tape, self-amalgamating tape on there, just to help it seal a little better. And as this one's getting a little bit old, it needs to just be worked a little bit, otherwise it gets a bit sticky. And we will find something to pump it out onto. Take that off there. Actually, we'll leave that on there. Feed that through. And turn it on. Push the button. And you can see it's coming through. And as all the air disappears, it does slow down a little. No. So that's started. So once you're at that point, you know it's going to feed. I need to dump that down. So you can wander off to the end of the cable and just start pulling. And there you go. It comes out at a very acceptable rate.